All right, everybody, put your hands together. Coming to the stage, a hilarious comedian, Jared Moskowitz, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, what's up, guys? How are you? Cool. It's good to be here. Real quick off the top, anyone here hate their friends? Good, good. A couple of you feel the way I do. I'm getting to the age now where a lot of my friends are starting to become homeowners, which I don't like because I still rent and fuck them for thinking they're better than me. But the thing that I think is like the most annoying about it is my friends who are now homeowners will complain to me about it, knowing full well that I still rent a one-bedroom apartment, and I just hate it. Like, recently my friend was like, "Oh, Jared, owning a home, it's great and all, but it's a lot of work. You know, I mean, when something breaks, we have to fix it ourselves. We don't have a landlord to go to like you do." To which I was like, "Really? So you mean anytime your water pressure gets low, you don't have to spend half a day tracking down and negotiating with a lecherous 68-year-old Israeli veteran? Is that what you're telling me? No, having a landlord is way better. What would I do without Bogdan in my life?" My old apartment, I think my landlord there was up to some shady business, because the old place I used to live in was built in 1912, which makes it old enough to be registered as a historical site by the state of California. And like, that sort of gave me doubts when I was considering moving in there, you know? Like, I don't know if I'm gonna live under a roof that was constructed during a time in our nation's history where you could just like bribe the safety inspector with a handshake and a carton of Chesterfield cigarettes. It made me feel uneasy. But my landlord, on the other hand, he used how old the building was as like a selling point, you know? Like, I guess he thought trading modern day amenities for Hollywood nostalgia would seal the deal. He's like giving me a tour. I'm asking him very reasonable questions. I'm like, "Hey, does this place come with like a dishwasher?" He goes, "No, but Walt Disney's nephew died of rickets here." Oh, okay. First and last month you need? Okay. But I am single. What? I know, I couldn't believe it either when I found out. It's crazy. Anyone else single? I'm doing online dating. And you guys doing online dating? You look very hip and young. No? Okay. Well, if you're not, good for you. It's terrible. I hate every second of it. I'm on the online dating sites, the apps, the Tinders, the Bumbles, the OkCupid. They're all garbage. I hate them all. And it's weird. Like, when you're on these sites as much as me, you start to notice some patterns among the dating profiles among the women. Specifically, like, I've noticed that 75% of girls on dating sites, their About Me profile, they all describe themselves as an adventure seeker. That's what they say. I'm an adventure seeker, you know? Let you know that they're like fun and spontaneous, right? But I gotta be honest, guys. I've gone out with a few of these quote-unquote adventure seekers, and they never really live up to the hype. Like, apparently in LA, like, most girls' idea of an adventure is like wearing open-toed sandals to the farmer's market. It's like, it's not really that exciting. But it's like to the point where I think the next time I go out with a girl who calls herself an adventure seeker, I'm just going to completely call her on her bluff. Just like pick her up, like wearing a miner's helmet holding a treasure map. Just be like, "Krista, right? Nice to meet you. You might want to change your shoes because you and I are gonna go search for the amulet of the Ice Phoenix, huh? How's that sound, adventure seeker? Pack only what you can carry. We leave at first light." Yeah, but I am single, which, sorry to say, but it means I watch a lot of pornography, because it's what you do. And I don't know how you guys feel about the modern state of pornography. You look like nice people. You probably don't have an opinion on it, but I do, and I'm going to share it with you. I am of the belief that modern day porn has just gotten way too aggressive and like hardcore, and it's borderline scary, where I like find myself tapping out pretty early on in porn. And like, on the one hand, I kind of understand it, you know? Like, porn is like any other art form. It has to consistently push boundaries, right? You know, sometimes those boundaries are huge. Sometimes those boundaries can be dark. Sometimes in porn, those boundaries are huge and they're dark and they're being pushed into an Asian teen's mouth, which is my personal favorite genre. No, I'm kidding. My taste in porn is actually pretty vanilla. By that, I mean I don't watch interracial. Just kidding. But there's this weird thing that they do in porn now, which I don't like, where like the cameraman will interview the girl right after the scene is done, which is weird because she's not looking her best at that time, let's say. And I'm always amazed at how like complimentary and elated these girls in porn are right after a scene is done, considering they look like they've just been pulled out of a burning kitchen. Like their hair's all messed up, they're gasping for air. And it's also weird that like, I feel like now the trend is like the more degrading the act done to the girl is, the more they enjoy it, which is oddly disturbing. Like the cameraman will be like, "So Lexi, how was your first scene?" And then Lexi will be like, "Oh my God, I loved it. I love when he choked me and pulled my hair and called me a whore. And then when he took that rusted protractor and carved Helter Skelter into my abdomen. Then when he grabbed me from behind and he burned that picture of my great grandmother at Ellis Island." You're like, "God damn, Lexi. Are filthy." You guys are cool. It's good to be back here in LA. I was out of town for a little bit, visiting my friends and family back east in Philadelphia. Oh, okay. Couple of you have clearly never been there. Nicely done. But no, Philly's okay. It's weird because, you know, I've been living in Los Angeles now for like, I don't know, like a little over 7 years. And it's weird because now I notice whenever I go home and I hang out with my friends from Philadelphia who still live there and have never left, I started to notice that they are all accusing me of having gone Hollywood. That is what they'll say to me. They'll be like, "Jared, you've gone Hollywood, man." But I was thinking about it, you guys. You see, I don't think the problem is so much that like I've gone Hollywood, right? See, I think the problem is more that my friends have stayed Philadelphia. I think that's the bigger issue. Like, we were hanging out recently. My one friend starts giving me a hard time. He's like, "Oh, look at Mr. Hollywood. All of a sudden, he thinks he's too good to take a handful of Percocets and yell the N-word at a cop." "Hey, fellas, Channing Tatum over here doesn't want to throw batteries at a toddler wearing a Dallas Cowboys onesie. He's Mr. Hollywood." Yeah, that's it, guys. I'm definitely a Hollywood snob, and you guys definitely aren't reckless savages. But look, guys, of course I'm kidding about using the N-word. I do not use that word, okay? I've only said the N-word twice my whole life. That's true. Once was quoting the great Eddie Murphy. The other was quoting my great Uncle Murphy. All right, thank you guys very much.
Keep going. What a crowd. Thanks for watching Come to the Stage, season 3. You guys have been awesome. We'll see you next time. Good night, everybody. Good night.